And welcome back to our coverage, a continuing coverage, I would say, of the North American LCS. We've got the teams loading in for our next fight. It's going to be CounterLogic Gaming versus Complexity. And with Curse's win over LMQ, they have secured the last playoff spot, which leaves Complexity and Evil Geniuses on the outside looking in.
Yeah, so unfortunately, playoffs are off the table for Complexity. They are now battling, though, for positioning with an eye towards that promotion tournament. And remember, the seventh place team does get second choice of which team they face from the Challenger League, which is actually pretty important because who they face could be the difference between whether or not they return to the LCS. And of course, Complexity, they are a lively bunch, so they're going to have some fun regardless of the scenario.
That's right. It's the GG, let's have some fun mentality. On the other side of this matchup, CLG can reassert control over fourth place right here with a win.
And they kind of need it. The CLG sub-squad are enjoying their time back in the LCS, but it's not just fun and games for the team. They're now playing to win, because in their match against Evil Geniuses, they started out with an early lead, getting three kills right off the bat. They kept the pressure up throughout the game, and they found some favorable engages. And once again, we kind of have to mention Nguyen, who had another big game bullying the top lane and getting some early kills on Inox. This CLG sub-squad could actually take a win off.
Well, yeah, let's take a closer look at the teams. On the blue side, it's going to be CounterLogic Gaming, the CLG sub-squad. Nguyen in the top lane, ThinkCard in the jungle, Hotshot GG himself in the mid lane, Chaox at AD carry, and Baby as support.
And on the red side, it is Complexity. Westrice in the top lane, Kez in the jungle, Prawley in mid lane, ROBERTxLEE on AD carry, and of course, Bubbadub on support.
Oh, so interesting, these games. This game, I feel like it's going to be just like at each other's throat, just like we had previously, the 20-20 matchup. Complexity is a team that wants to win early. CLG, we'll call them half alumni, half kind of the new class.
Complexity is a team that wants to get ahead early.
Right.
But they win late most of the time.
This is true. Yeah. That's way to clarify. Thank you, because that is the truer statement.
Yeah.
But for CLG, they're kind of doing everything. Very sporadic. Sporadic and chaotic at the same time. If Nguyen got going, they kind of worked off of that. So who could it be this time?
It's funny, because ROBERTxLEE made that tweet earlier on in the season. How do you prepare for a team that has no idea what they are doing? CLG is actually a team that has no idea what they are doing right now. The crazy thing about this, though, is this game has really severe playoff implications between the 4th, 5th, and 6th seeds. The way these standings are working out right now, Riv, is if CLG, Curse, and Dignitas lost out, so that would mean CLG losing the game now and their game against Cloud9 tomorrow, it would mean Curse losing the game to TSM tomorrow, and it'll mean Dignitas losing the game to LMQ, which are actually all realistic possibilities, there would be what looks like a three-way tie between the teams.
Yeah.
But because of the way all the head-to-heads work, Curse would be the 4th seed, surprise. Dignitas would be the 6th seed, and CLG would be in 5th. So there's a lot of crazy stuff. A win here for CLG makes sure that they do not fall to the 6th seed, because that could happen if they lose out and Dignitas wins one of their games because they lose the tiebreaker to Curse.
Well, Prawley and the team, they are one of the best at dashing dreams if you're hoping for something to come out on the good side. So we'll see if they can do that. Hotshot GG and crew on the side of CLG with a big wave. They're ready to get
Chaos.
The game going. These guys are almost into champion select, getting a quick chat with all the players, making sure they are ready. No phones on the body.
Baby had something in his pocket
phones.
Trying to break the rules.
No phones. No phones, no bananas. We saw them confiscate that from Lemonation earlier in the year.
Yeah.
It's cereal up on that desk.
You're not allowed cereal on the desk either.
Not allowed cereal on the desk either. What am I saying? So with this, Champion Select beginning in just a few for our final game here before the Challenger Series Finals. Better stay tuned here.
Big, long day in the LCS.
Absolutely.
Studios.
Super week offering many
plays. There it is. Finally,
a Maokai
ban.
Always.
Come on, guys.
Gotta cut down the tree sometime. Nguyen's like, that was me. I banned it.
Yeah, he's having so much fun.
They all are.
This week.
This is great. I love it. Very jovial subs that CLG has brought to the table. Syndra banned out the Ziggs as well. Excessive amounts of wave clear will not be had this game. Isn't Lulu getting banned out here? A lot of AP on the focus. What do we got? Any AD carries? Or is it going to just run free?
Getting at that Kog'Maw tree. Ah,
yeah.
There.
Now you had to say it.
You jinxed it right there, Riv.
Did you do that? Because I get it.
No, I didn't. I get it now, though. Yeah.
One more. Uno Mas from Complexity for the bans. Will it be another AD carry, or do they allow CLG to pick one of those top tiers that we've been seeing? Yeah. I don't even really call it top tier. It's just really what's been used.
We got to have that quick interview with Hotshot during the tech delay we had earlier. They say how they're getting better every single game. Yeah, there we go. First pick, Trist.
Boom.
Probably going on to Chaos there. Come on, Westrice. See, this would not be the smart thing to do if he were to pick a Kali, but it would be the fun thing to do.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, Complexity still wants to win these games to make sure they are the seventh seed because EG is on a tear. And they play Complexity tomorrow, actually.
He's looking for a 4-0 Super Week, as I say that yawning. No yawns.
No yawns today from them.
Kez, what do you want? You got your Elise. You can get the jungler. Think card. I gotta say, think card in the end. Like CLG's been coming up with quite a few of these first bloods, and that top lane has been
first blood in both their games.
Yeah.
Sub squad.
Yeah, there's the Elise. All right. So that's a good pickup for Kaz. The Braum gets handled by Bubbadub. Interesting. He still makes plays on that, but personally, I like Bubbadub's thrash a little better. That's their choice. The Braum gets locked in. They're gonna go for some Winter's Bite here with also a Spider Bite. Think card and Hotshot to show their hand. Or somebody else's hand.
Could be anyone's hand.
Could be anybody's.
At the moment, it is Think Card and Hotshot, though. They are the hands clicking the pick and ban buttons right now.
This is true. Hotshot says, maybe. I like that.
Shall we see Zillion again from the young Hotshot GG? Think Card nodding his head in approval of the Lee Sin hover for himself. You're like, yeah, I just hovered that Lee Sin. I can do this. It's a fun situation for ThinkCard to be in because this group of COG, it's Nguyen, Hotshot, and Chaox, two guys with a lot of LCS experience.
Yep.
And then ThinkCard and Baby, these guys that have barely been on the stage yet flung into the same situation. They got the jungle gym being started there, Threshly Sin.
Able to get everywhere. Everybody's jumping right now. Teemo Sejuani.
Yeah, the very realistic Sejuani hover from Prawley right there. There's going to be some reason he doesn't want to lock that in, though.
There's a better choice.
What's the name of that Diamond 1 Sejuani main that always does AMAs on Reddit for some reason? He exists. So. Crowd in a very jovial mood here for the CLG.
Yeah, they are. Count down. Oh, my gosh.
Up.
Lol.
It's because Hotshot doesn't play it. This actually happened to them in their first game against Dig. It fell all the way through pick and ban because Shifter didn't want to play it. But yeah, Hotshot doesn't play Kassadin, so teams are either making CLG ban it or just letting it go through.
So now Hotshot plays Alistar middle, right?
That's the logical progression of things.
The alley lock-in, bring in the Mad Cow. All right, let's see. CLG, ball's in your court now. You guys let a Kassadin through here. Probably doesn't wreak havoc with that Kassadin in lane either. He gets it from the bottom lane. They love the focus, get ROBERTxLEE going, get the lock in, a Nidalee and a Zillion on the last picks. I was gonna say the Zillion did not impress me from CLG, but they're going for it again.
And Westrice with an Aurelia to go against the Nidalee.
Right, that counter.
It is
as it is,
one
as
of the
stands.
Things you can pick against it to have a
yeah.
fair matchup. So a Nidalee pick for COG, but not a Hotshot Nidalee GG right here. That's too bad. That'll be a very fast and annoying team to play against. Good thing Prawley has Kassadin. That should help them out pretty well. These COG games are always chaos.
So we got
absolute chaos.
Well, I was trying to see what CLG puts together here. They got so much utility to deliver to a member that could actually become very strong if Chaox gets all that at the right time. But then again, you're going to be dodging out a lot. You have the crowd control, the long range of Complexity, and the craziness of their style of play. Now to be matched by CLG sub squad, this is going to be nothing less than awesome.
It should be pretty good.
As the team's loaded to the rim.
Still backing them up, too.
Oh, yeah.
They're 0-2.
The crowd wants this game. So do we. Let's do it. We're going to total up the votes on LOLesports.com. Right now, CLG is leading Complexity with 71% of that vote. But even you here in the crowd can change that.
Of course they are. You can continue to vote, though, throughout the game by tweeting hashtag CLG win or hashtag COLWIN2 at LOL Esports.
A lot of L's.
If I had to guess, I would say CLG Win's going to have about 80% of these tweets. However, COL Win does get a lot of tweets, especially if we're asking them to do 80 minutes of the dream. That's not the hashtag this time.
No, it's not. So what's your final prediction when we see it in the game of the percentages? Because we do this beforehand.
Oh, we're going to predict the percentages of the first time we see it?
Yeah.
The problem is, since it's live voting, whatever I say is going to influence it.
Oh, anyway. Damn, that's right. All right, don't listen.
77% for CLG.
77 CLG?
Yeah, the first time we show it when we load into the game. Yeah.
I'm going to be like 68.
All right, are we doing Price is Right rules here?
Yeah. Absolutely. If you're over, you're done.
Okay.
All right, we're in the game. Let's go. Final one before the Challenger Series finals, which you better keep your butt parked for.
Should have known we were doing Price is Right rules before my bet. It's going to be under 77 now.
Just be like $1, man.
Yeah. Or we could both be wrong. That'll be fun.
It happens.
Yeah.
We can still be wrong, Jet. Consumables on the side of Complexity as they're looking to get their drink on this game. Let me see Doran's all across CLG's. Summoner's Rift. Thank you again. Very nice of you. Very early.
CLG actually pulled off that 3-buff start in their game earlier. One of the only 3-buff starts we've seen in the NA LCS this season. Ooh, he got hit. He's got a skill rocket jump. Yep. 70. Ah, man.
Wait a minute.
You guessed 67.
Door number two was
perfect.
If
it keeps going lower, you're going to both. Now you win.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Rick.
Ah. 30 seconds. All right. I'm going to take that home with me today. Slow movement. Very early wards here coming out in all the same spots. We've been seeing them. Complexity is going to try to put pressure on this, and Chaos actually sees that one nicely. So that's a little bit of information. CLG. And we have nothing from CLG. Actually, we do deep. It was just vision back and forth. So we have that red ward going in. Westrice might be seen.
I'm excited for Nguyen's Nidalee to see how it works out. Westrice has actually done pretty well against Nidalee. As long as he's not on Gragas. That was when he didn't do very well.
Had to bring it up.
If I didn't bring it up, someone else would have.
Yeah, this is a true statement. You're on a roll today. All right, so we get help over towards blue. We'll see how Hotshot does with bombs this game. He was putting bombs on everybody the last time.
Throws them around
all
willy-nilly.
Yeah,
I mean, everybody gets a bomb.
It's like consolation prize. You came to the fight, you get a bomb.
There's one.
Brawly's there, you get a bomb. Nicely done. He doesn't discriminate whatsoever. So Hotshot, not going to win that shield game, though.
You get a bomb. Now, will he use his Q to try and shield before the bomb goes off, or will he just take damage?
Question answered.
Takes damage. Magic Shield of Kasten should be able to be used pretty well. Oh, and the Magic Shield's going to wear off before the bomb hits now. So nice. Hotshot doing decent trading, but he took so much minion fire from auto attacks. He's low himself. Double bomb, maybe. Is he going to do double bomb? It's a lot of mana to do double bomb level 2. A lot of zillions wait until level 3 before firing off a double bomb.
Hopefully they can... Whoa!
Oh, whoa! Whoa!
That's flash. Oh!
The level 2 of Nidalee is brutally strong.
I don't think Westrice was prepared for that to happen so quickly. Very interesting. So it does not seem like, or it does seem like, I should say, that Flask is going to come into play. Westrice chugging down those usages. Usages. Word.
See, Hotshot's at full mana now. He can double bomb as he pleases. Here goes. Slows him down. He didn't go for double bomb.
That's one slow. There's the flash. That's what they wanted.
That's right.
That's the return trip.
Kobe was talking about this the other day. Hotshot always mentions you have to skill up that E instead of the Q. Everyone wants to put 2 points in Q early. To get more damage, but the E just gives too much utility. It escapes ganks and also sets them up. That's why they burn the flash.
A lot of people disregard the effectiveness of slow in the early game. You used to have Shyvana come out of the jungle with exhaust blowing flashes early game.
Hook doesn't land.
A lot of different ways to get that flash out early. It only takes another trip to the lane to get the kill in for first blood. However, though, ThinkCar, like he's saying, just hanging off in the wing. Very patient here. Didn't even want to try to get an attack on. They have the chance. Maybe they just don't want to show without having all the vision of Kez right now.
Spend a lot of time in that brush. A lot of time. Flash!
Oh, the flash from Baby. They want even more of this. Oh, Bubbadub steps in front. Chaos with a good switch, but there's not enough focus damage on just one to get the kill down.
Yikes. They did not even burn a single summoner spell from the complexity bottom lane, yet Baby had to flash in. Not a good gank there.
Yep, now that gives Kez the knowledge that he's safe to the top lane with C and Think card. See how this works.
Well, he gets a slow. It was not low enough for the stun.
Slalom! Too many minions!
Good damage.
Can't squeeze through. All right, he saves his flash, though. Definitely better off. Westrice still down that flash. About halfway through that summoner cooldown to get back up here. So the teleport should be nice and easy here for Nguyen. 24 to 30 in that lane. So Westrice using that flask to keep himself healthy.
Well, at least he forced him back to base. Yeah. Had to burn that teleport, whereas Westrice still holds his, unless he decides to burn it quick like here. Yep, he does.
Oh, interesting.
Gotta get those minions.
True.
Although he really could have saved it.
Yeah, Nien's on the freeze. He kind of killed that first wave, so maybe he was like, oh, he's pushing it. But Nien with the mind games. Slow in every lane, pretty much. Without this first blood coming through, there isn't super amount of crowd control between these middle and top lanes that the junglers have been visiting. Just the slows.
A very early sightstone by Kez. Before he even gets an upgrade to his Hunter's Machete.
It's something he brought to the team immediately when he filled in for Broken Shard was a plethora of wards and vision for Complexity to start the early game, where they like to win, or would like to win, I should say. They grab the lead. And then push that to about 50 minutes.
Yeah. And if we've seen anything in the past few games, this COG team starts falling apart when things get crazy.
Yeah.
Or not when things get crazy, when things get late. And one mistake could mean the end of the game. They're all about risking it all.
This
could be a dive. Think Carter spent so much time waiting in brushes. If they don't get a kill here, he's going to be feeling really far behind. Westrice has no flash, though. Don't juke that way. He's dead. That's just...
Oh, yeah. With skill shots, putting yourself against a wall only denies you.
Look at the size of that minion wave he's missing too. Nguyen is going to have complete control of that lane when he comes back. He already had a level advantage onto Westrice.
That's incredible. Good plays. Bubbadub again, stepping in front. Nicely played.
Baby trying to throw a lantern out for the enemy. Be like, come on, get me. Anyway, they're completely safe. It's really going to be about this top lane, whether Nguyen can run away with this game.
Oh, he's letting it eat every minion too.
Nguyen has been doing so well in the top lane in his first two games. And this Nidalee, 20 CS advantage, turret already.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
Yikes.
Playing very strong. Nguyen is definitely one of the champions that if you get him going, he can control that snowball very well. Remember his play back on Elise, back at MLGs. He was a very strong Elise top lane and would never let a lead go. So now around the map, beautiful job by Complexity to get a little bit back there as Westrice has had a hell of a time in the top lane and it's not going to get any easier.
Jeez. So also got to mention that Bizarro CLG here has gotten first blood.
Again? Yeah.
In all three of their games. And believe me, it's not because people are underestimating CLG. It's just because they don't really know what they're going to do. The
CLG or the other team?
The element of surprise is huge. A little bit of both, to be honest.
True story. Kind of seeing the hover of Think card around. Hasn't really been able to capitalize on too much other than that kill in the top lane. But that first blood shuts down Westrice, who has actually, if it's not probably a ROBERTxLEE, been the one to keep Complexity in a game. Had a pretty good Maokai game earlier where he started off a little shady and then was able to bring himself upright. Let's see if the rest of the team can get each other in that position. A little bit of camaraderie and help. Definitely going to be the buddy system for Complexity here in this one. They're definitely not doing solo fights. Maybe Prowly.
Oh, maybe. Dub. Do you want it? Yeah, he was thinking about shielding for the bomb. He's like, I'll give you some armor and MR so I can take damage too. He just let Prowly take the damage because he got a catalyst and a crystalline flask to sustain back up. I think that super early sightstone from Kez was an attempt to try and control the insanity in this game. Complexity is very content with this game going late and just winning by being more organized. Complexity wins a lot of really late games anyway, and they've seen that even though CLG has stayed close in gold for a lot of their games, they've really fell apart once the real fights start happening. Seems to be what Complexity's plan's going to be here.
Yeah. CLG themselves said it gets a little solo queue-y once they get to that late game and everybody's doing their own thing.
Prawly has not been spotted out by wards as of yet. It's going to be on Baby to get enough distance away so we can Lantern in Chaos for a save.
They're hauling ass out of here. Like, it doesn't feel right. Way too much dark on the map. We have somebody missing in mid lane. But Prawly, wow, all of CLG is closing in as well on this mid lane with that rotation of Prawly.
Nguyen with the roam knows he has control of top lane. Time to get control of mid.
Do they have enough? One more minion wave on that one. Nguyen coming down here. Looks like he's going to be going straight Triforce. Brute in Italy. Going to try to be doing all the damage that he can throughout the game. Already a Lizard built up onto Think Card, so he's got a good bit of damage capitalized onto that. And they're going to head right back to Westrice. Hope to get this flash out of him.
That trade didn't work out too well for Hotshot.
Imagine if you could actually jump back on Zillion and be like, eat your own bomb.
Yeah.
Take this damage.
Or if you could actually turn back time. That trade didn't work out. Oh. I'll try it again. Not do it this time.
That would be pretty annoying. Hot shot. Looking to bait in Prawly here for the Rift Walk. So Think Card's in range, but he's just giving him the pulse. He says, here you go. Thanks for casting spells. He's just toying with him right now. All right, so safe play from Prawly. He's really not putting himself into any scary situations. And more roam from Nguyen. Good job. Very omnipresent here.
Yeah. Nguyen is going to need to create a lot of pressure here. He took the turret so early, so Westrice is not getting denied on farm any longer.
Yeah.
So he can't actually extend his advantage over him much. Therefore, he needs to create advantages for the team more so.
So he's playing two lanes.
He's trying to.
He's making it really work almost.
But because Complexity got the dragon when Nguyen was top lane anywho, the gold is staying really close and Westrice is climbing back. And unless Nguyen gets a few more kills, Westrice will reach a point where he can deal with Nidalee again. And will make all that early game moves by Nguyen irrelevant.
So close. No cigar on that one, Bubbadub. And Baby, trying to find each other for a bit of a hook. We haven't seen too much action towards this bottom lane. We got a good lead, but ROBERTxLEE about 15 CS. Hot shot, throwing on the speed for a dive. Prawly knew it on that one, so he's going to try to get more damage on the turret. That calls Kez up. And maybe this gank by Think Card will work in the bottom now. Looks like they're really hesitant, though.
Yeah.
Not much. Think Card wasn't even moving on that one. Slow play.
You can see ROBERTxLEE's Caitlyn is definitely just trying to be as defensive as possible. You know, they got the Trist pick taken away. And they're trying to just be safe. They know that late game, a team fight, Nidalee and Zillion are not going to provide super heavy threat, and they think the cast and Aureli will be enough to close down onto Chaox and neutralize him as a threat. Still looking pretty good late game for Complexity if they can stay close throughout this mid game.
And that Caitlyn is actually Robert's only second time playing it in the LCS. He was always Corki and twitching after that. We saw his Corki didn't work out so well yesterday.
A surprising amount of damage has been done to Prawly's turret. It's because Nguyen has been mid lane so many times.
Without the pressure of Westrice being able
to create anything,
this is the focus they really want onto Nguyen. He gets that. He could pounce over the wall. Do they position correctly? They do hit him up. One more to get out. The primal surge. Not there, because Bubbadub, he's already around the back side. It takes a lot to get Nguyen down, though.
Nguyen can only run back and forth between top and mid lane so many times before Complexity finds a way to punish. Nice kill there by Complexity.
Ooh, all right.
Tell
he says this fight's over.
Go away. He didn't need that ult anyway.
Uh-oh. Chaos.
Now, who needs an ultimate to peel enemies away from you when you can...
Back now. Head between your legs and pray. Oh, no. Oh, that's going to be a dragon and a Chaox. Rift walk in style.
Oh, whoa.
Wait a minute. Oh, my gosh. Oh.
If
I want to say he
calculated that. If he had his ultimate, he would have been able to kill Prawly right there.
He's so lucky he didn't get an extra crit and an explosive shot for the finalizing damage.
Yeah, he doesn't have any crit is one thing.
That's true.
Jeez.
Prawly playing that one. Looking at the inventory, he played it so calmly. Man, that was scary on our end. So this turret could drop just after. Chaos getting caught out a little bit. And it looks like he'll be just short of the Infinity Edge as well. Very unfortunate in that.
Whoa,
right into the middle. For a second, I thought Nguyen was a Kog'Maw, and I was like, why is Kog'Maw in the middle of the fight right now? But not even in the game. Good
Nguyen
play.
Is really trying to make plays, but they are not working as of now.
They are afraid of Nguyen, though. You can see Complexity is putting a lot of consideration.
From ROBERTxLEE.
Yeah.
Even though it cost them a flash to end the night.
You give and you get. You give and you use, I guess you would say. 137, that Infinity Edge is finished for ROBERTxLEE. That'll help. You get a little bit of damage from that BF and the pickaxe on your ultimate, but hopefully you can be in range for those headshot crits. Chaos is going to be putting out damage soon as well, and he'll have that attack speed utility if Nguyen's not split pushing the lanes. Back and forth. Hotshot actually can't get close enough. Very interesting to see Hotshot back on Zillion here within the NA LCS.
Kind of his best champion, feels like. Although this casted in by Prawly is being quite well played. Mm-hmm. Just eating bomb after bomb and still going after him. Oh, Complexity looking for a pretty aggressive gank here too.
Holds on the slow. Very nice from Prawly, but Hotshot's able to get out alive. The ultimate's down on Chrono Shift now. We'll see if Complexity can make a move here. They've actually just been milling about so much. It's been all laning phase after they really have control. And they have so many wards right on that red buff. They should be able to know what's going to happen here.
The pressure is building up for Complexity. COG will require some real coordination to try to fight against this one. They're such a skirmish-based team that they need to collapse at the right moments, but they just haven't been able to coordinate Complexity here. The cast-in is too mobile.
So we got Chaos and ROBERTxLEE. They're going to be solo farming. It's all up to pretty much Baby and Bubbadub here. They're rotating back and forth. The Nguyen rotation has stopped. That was creating options for the mid lane, but now that they have that down, it's something else. One last shot on this turret. See if they can get a hit onto Chaos. No rotation down from anybody here. Probably could get himself into a bad situation. He uses the Sonic Wave to get into the fight instead of the Safeguard to help him. Hotshot kind of leaves him out to dry here. Oh, the Q doesn't get him. Here, there's the auto attack. Kez in range.
Oh,
Hotshot throws on the alt. And Kez is forced to watch it happen. Goes down himself. A good save from Baby there as Nguyen gets himself in a sticky situation.
Hotshot was waiting on the cooldown of that alt to come back up, and it came up right as he finished Kez anyway, so he ended up not needing it. And a nice escape by Nguyen as well to try and keep CLG alive in this game despite the immense warding of Complexity. They end up falling in a turret dive where they did not have the vision. Kez definitely getting a little bit bloodthirsty there.
This is where it starts to come to be, Jat. When we start to get this next dragon back up, let's check this out first.
Hey, it was a bait by Hotshot, but it was also a Kez arriving at just the right moment here. He kicks Kez towards the threatening Hotshot. At this point, Kez couldn't go back.
I like
that. He decides to go forward even more. Hotshot had his ultimate, so he decided to try and get the kill, and he did so. It's hard to push away a Kasten. Can he get back in range? Nah. The cooldown of the ultimate is still pretty long.
Right.
At rank 1. Probably just hit level 11, though, which will reduce that Riftwalk cooldown substantially. It will now sit at 4.88 seconds.
And then just cost an astronomical amount of mana as you use it.
Correct. You can only use so many in a row.
Then it's like 1,200 mana. Can you Riftwalk? You'd have to have a big mana pool. Looks like we're going to have that come from Hotshot. He is going tier. That's really allowed Prawly to go Rod of Ages, and just with this built-up health, he's not taking too much damage in the Hotshot trades. So not too much focus on him has allowed Prawly to have his roam a little bit and get start his casted and fed game. Definitely not a ROBERTxLEE carry game, I should say. We always look at Complexity. One of these members is either going to do very, very well, and they kind of leave a lane to be. That lane this time is Westrice. I'll leave him to be this time. He's had a tough one. Triforce built up to a Phage and Sheen now as ThinkCard. They look like they're going to try to put him down even more here. Rough game for him.
Really has been a rough game. It's been a rough game for Westrice as well. Yet he's really just trying to farm off. He can hit his Trinity Force on Aurelia, he'll be alright. Chaos, that's a trap.
Oh! Second time Chaos has been caught out in the exact same position. Not enough wards down that side, but Gotta do what they can.
And CLG trying to make their own moves.
Hot damn!
Wait a minute! Wow!
What a pounce! I love that new kick.
This fight could go on for a while. Hotshot, how fast can you run away? Pretty fast, but he gets caught.
They're gonna kill him right away. Oh, he's gonna rift it on. Boom!
On a trap. Ooh. So, they did manage to finish off Westrice, but he barely got away. I do have to go back to that Chaos thing, though. He was pushed up without wards and without much knowledge of his surroundings. That's gonna hurt. And Complexity again uses the mobility of Kassadin to take advantage of the chaos in this game. Crawley is going to be really scary this game as soon as he gets some mana.
Very good game for Complexity here as they start to turn the tables. The first blood again in favor of CounterLogic Gaming, but it becomes the organization being ready a few steps ahead, and Complexity as a team. Oh. Wait a minute.
It's a little early.
Oh, he delivers that one over to Kaz. Gift wrap with a previous smite. It looks like we're going to have Nguyen very low. He'll stay alive from that burn, and now Complexity probably going to take out mid lane here. They didn't have too much damage on that turret, or to go, I should say.
Another noble effort from ThinkCard, but he was not able to outsmite Kez. He jumped in a little bit too early, and then just used his smite preemptively. Kez, with the team patience, was able to outsteal that, and now they push down mid.
Oh, the trap actually gets him on the big toe. He's going to be saved by the Chrono Shift, however. Good poke on the turret. That focus from ROBERTxLEE. He's really the only one with the long range. Kaz is focusing on doing damage. Probably's 3-0-1. Like you said, once he gets his mana built up, he starts to get a bigger pool to rift around. Things are going to be bad for Chaos. A Tristana already behind. It's not going to be a very good late game Tristana.
He is so far behind. ROBERTxLEE in terms of items.
Yeah.
It's a static shiv. Chaos is sitting on a longsword with his eye edge.
And he's not getting Nguyen. Nguyen's going to try to be split pushing, so he doesn't get that attack speed utility from the Primal Surge that he would be hoping for. You see, most Tristanos would get from a Nunu now. They like to combine with. Nguyen still being a menace in the top lane. It looks like he's not going to find anything until he meets Westrice again. Does Complexity try to push that? Or now do they let Triforce fight Triforce and try and hold the other lanes?
It would be great for CLG if Triforce could fight Triforce in a fair fight. But I really feel like Prawley will always be a spoiler when Nguyen tries to solo Westrice here.
Uh-huh.
Westrice is going to neutralize Nguyen as best as possible and just try and hold out until Nguyen is there. Nguyen is going to do his best to try and make a carry out of this game, but it's going to be tricky with Kassadin on the map.
They've left him alone to do so. The only people he's seen really is ThinkCard. Nobody else is trying to take experience off of this top lane. It hasn't been a three-lane gank. So CLG's focus has definitely been to figure out how Prawley is going to try and carry the game. And right now, he's got outside the box, and he's all by his lonesome. The teleport is not up here, so it could be a very big play, and they'll have to trade that turret.
Still no teleport on Prawley when he's pushing that
wave.
But at the same time, who on CLG could actually stop him? Nguyen, that's too many people for you, man.
Bam! Winter's Bite gets locked up as well. That means the pressure's relieved in the top lane here, and Complexity can start to move. They've pulled now Chaos down to the bottom. He's going to have to soak up that farm, and we're going to get a side swipe fight here if Prawley tries to come in on Baby.
Kind of feels like Complexity's handling CLG better than the other teams have so far. They're really just starting to starve CLG out and punish them for their miscoordination.
Really great movement around the map for Complexity. The organization now really coming into play. A 4,000 gold lead as they brute force down the second tier. ThinkCard gets himself in a position, but also gets locked up quite hard. Nice stop from Baby there. They're able to walk out safely. They have a chance to go for an inhibitor turret now.
Yeah. We'll see what CLG has up their sleeve, though. They've had a few of those stealth attacks in the past. We think to their first game of this week against Dignitas. They just started waiting randomly in brushes for people to come out. There's such good ward coverage by Complexity, though, and not nearly as much stealth by CLG this time, as in they have no stealth. So the sneak attacks won't be as easy to formulate.
They have great wards towards that top side for Nguyen, but nothing to formulate down the center of the map. That's complexities. They own the entire security system in their side of the jungle. And only that, oh, they have two sight stones still. CLG is just kind of lacking in wards here. They have gone back to buy, so maybe they're just biding time until they need to go into those spots. Looks like they're actually giving complexity all the room they want right now, though. Playing very timid, CLG is.
They kind of have to.
Yeah.
Everyone needed Nguyen to kind of carry this one, and he has done a great job, but the rest of the team is collapsing down on him. And when he took that turret so early, he couldn't make enough of the team advantage to have the rest of the team provide adequate distraction.
Wow, this has some health too.
Westrice beginning the battle.
Ooh, through the uprights. Nguyen's taking some good damage, being a damage builder himself. That volatile spider cutting right through his HP. 14, however. So he's faring quite well in the level category. Complexity's putting a lot on this last turret. They do not want to lose that lane pressure off of Baron, or just lose that lane pressure in general. Also causing Nguyen to not be able to get anything out of it. We'll see if this is the last time he needs to go at it. So much focus, Kez, again. Bottom lane.
It's because there's no other distractions on CLG.
That's true, no pressure.
Chaos has been scared off of farming because of one too many sneak attacks by Complexity. Probably can collapse on people, and Hotshot has very little pressure on the mid lane with his bomb shoving.
It's like zero pressure. They're setting up for ganks everywhere. They're like slowly bird watching. And now they finally found one. He's gonna fly away.
Oh! Weez needs that ult to come back up. Oh, it's gonna get
him! He just wanted that right around the back of Baron Den. What a shot. What a great hit. Westrice giving Nguyen some business, it seems like, there for a second. He doesn't target him, however, though, so Nien's going to be forced to back up. He calls for the cavalry on this one. It's a really thick wall. Can you make the flash?
He doesn't even try.
Doesn't try to.
Think Guard had a Sonic Wave on him, so we could have followed him through. Nice catch there. Complexity trying to make the best of a bad situation, pushing mid as three, but two people on their team are dead.
Chaos, top turret. Will he test side to go back? Hotshot here, he's playing the no back for you game. Take some ice ball on the face. He'll be all right, though. They'll be able to still chase.
On mana, but they're going to try and continue this chase.
As long as they keep vision of CLG, they know they can't hit that blue pill, and they have to stay in. Oh, the flash! ROBERTxLEE hitting up Bubbadub. They actually get the double knockup. What a play for CLG to keep going on this one.
Still alive, but Prawly's there.
Unfortunate that. Chaos did back. He could still be fighting, but they go one for one overall in the fight. Uh-oh, Westrice trying to come in big. Oh, is this? I was going to say, is that Prawly? But it was Westrice, and he gets knocked back right away. They're not giving up, though, Jack. Looks like they're going to try to go right down the middle here.
Jeez.
Nope, head in the jungle. Never mind. Dragon is up. All right.
This is really impressive by CLG as this sub squad because they seem to find these ways to make these games crazy. The Q to ward jump to flash to get super range on ROBERTxLEE creates that kill. Pop down Robert, Hotshot gets the kill. Real nice.
Real kick from Think Card. CLG not afraid to take chances in situations where it will count. Seraph's Embrace coming up now for Hotshot. GG gives himself a little bit more safety. The Zhonya's play now capable from Prawly. As we see a lot of defense after those Triforce is starting to be built up by the top laners. These fights could start going pretty long.
They really could. I mean, we saw Westrice was starting to neutralize Nguyen a little bit, but that was when they got the backup of Think Card to punish Westrice. He's going to second guess all inning Nguyen. Now, they brought a bit more backup this time. See, this is the COG special right now. You'd think 28 minutes into the game, you would want people around Baron. You thought wrong. Oh, nice stun by Westrice. Beautiful flash.
Locks him down. They get the turret, finally. 28 minutes, bottom turret falls. Usually that's one of the first in the game, but you can see how just crazy this one has kind of gone back and forth. Early game consisted of Nien's roam down to the mid lane. First blood again, went to CLG. Whoa, very close. Complexity thinks they have the upper hand, but two more members of CLG show up. Spiders sacrificing themselves to go down. Wow, so much just fire between both of these teams. They want fights.
Chaos is an item behind ROBERTxLEE.
Yeah, still.
But he is on Tristana, and if Nguyen could give him that attack speed, he would still be pretty threatening. this is what Complexity needs to do. They say, enough of this funny business. It's time to get vision control over the Baron Pit.
Haha, success. Well, they don't lay any down just yet. They want to clear it. See if they can pull Complex or CLG over here. And now we go for someone's going for Baron. We're going to dictate the mid turret. That's what CLG says. Gonna have good attacks coming up here. A nice caster wave actually to help Robert actually crush down this turret with Kez. And CLG will try to make Complexity march to the beat of their drum here with this mid lane push. Chaos with that static shiv. Doesn't have to clear any waves, but he can still get some good shots onto the turret. He's not doing too much damage. He doesn't have much protection, though.
The hotshot zillion revive is nice and all, but it hasn't really saved too many lives. It usually just prolongs their demise.
Wards by Complexity. Very great right now. CLG is walking into just a bed of them, and they think they're in the safe zone as they've denied vision for Complexity. Probably feels comfortable to start roaming the jungle alone here. Sees it. Baby gets left alone, and they're going to try to take him
out. How alone
is
he, though? There's Chaos.
Ooh, I don't know if they wanted to go fully for that fight. This might have just been to deter them, but everybody's in it now. CLG is converging on every one of CLG. Or rather, Complexity is converging on CLG, I should say.
Hotshot coming in really late, but he's here now.
Entering the fight, he is going down to half health already. ROBERTxLEE on the outside, just hitting the wall up. Probably he's going to go down. They should leave him to die. That's a shutdown, actually, that Hotshot gets onto Prolly.
And in a fight where Complexity had the jump on him, CLG still trades two for two with a really late teleport coming in from Nguyen. I don't think he had a viable teleport target until later in on that fight. Quite a turn of events. ThinkR wants to go big. They have the zillion ult again.
Whoa. ThinkR trying to make plays all day long.
That's the thing about this hotshot zillion. Max's rewind second, you get those ultimates up so quickly. If you can just extend the fight a little bit, you get two of them. But this fight in particular, you can see there's nowhere for Nguyen to teleport to. He's probably telling people to ward, put down a ward, put down a ward. Finally, I think someone sneaks a ward over the back wall there. Yeah, he was screaming it so loud, two people put wards down. Nguyen is able to come in as a lot of bombs hit Complexity and Chaos is staying safe as well. Nguyen finishes one kill off in the back, goes all in to get probably low enough for the bomb to finish him. Style points for the style zoom as well. And it's an 8-kill to 8 game with a 4,000 gold advantage.
And that, as the game goes longer, that gold at 4,000 pretty much could mean nothing. It'd be a 0 gold lead. It's about how these players use what they have.
True. One thing we have seen, though, especially with zillion compositions and Nidalee compositions, is the later the game goes, the less effective they become.
That's
unless
true.
They have a monumental gold and experience advantage.
Well, level 17 to Westrice is 15 right now, only really applies to that lane. Actually, I'm a liar. Probably is 15 too. Nguyen is having quite the game. Hotshot also at 16, so they're seeing those last levels of ultimates come in as well.
That zillion passive, 8% more experience for your team.
That's right. Good
it
call.
Pays off sometimes. Thinking all the way back to the start of the game, Nguyen hit level 2 a little early. Wasn't accounting for the zillion. Here we go.
Baby. That's a good hit. Westrice gets the full team passive disengage from the Tenacity, but it's going to be too much DPS to come out.
Oh, Complexity. Man. This is a good fight for...
How? They had all the wards in this area. CLG took the time, played it methodically, and have completely retaken control.
Prolly wasn't there. Baby was fast enough with the boots of mobility. They just found a fight. Now they're going for Baron. CLG could pull ahead if they were able to get this. It is a 3v5. Prolly's going back to base. It's a 5v2. Can Kez steal? They're
very
teleporting in.
Coordinated coming into the Baron. Baron down 3,900 HP. Definitely not in this fight range. 2,300. ThinkR still on it. 15, 14. The spike goes down. Kez gets it and he goes down valiantly.
Kez with another clutch smite. And they're still chasing down Prolly. How
they
fast
got a
can he
safe base on this one. If Prolly can't get out, it could be big things over the wall the other way, but it's going to be a bomb on him again. He has seen that fate and he finds it once again. Hot shot, Chrono Shift is down, but we've seen that come up quickly. What a back and forth,
Jeez.
And a great steal from Kez overall.
COG has not had luck at the Baron Pit this week. Every game seems to be decided around that spot, and they just cannot get the coordination together. That time, Kez amongst the chaos. Cold blood in that guy's veins. He's able to do that smite steal against COG.
What
a
risky,
really.
Risky move.
So he's not afraid to take a risk, that's for sure. Anyway, this fight. Prawley gets hooked in. Beautiful hook by Baby. They try and lock him down. You can see, no one, like, they stopped focus on Baron when it was in smite range. That is...
Yeah, they tried to kill Kez.
Yeah, they either have to pull off a little bit earlier or fully commit to finishing it off, because that actually gave Kez the easiest smite steal in the world.
I didn't realize he killed Baby there. That's great. So many fast things happen. All right.
Hey, these games deliver at least.
Oh, yeah. Definitely have to. Almost even gold up to 35 minutes into the game. CounterLogic Gaming trying to come out with the team they have recently put together here in the better interest of the main team.
True.
See how that works out. CLG so far with the first bloods have found not the best results, but a few wins.
It's amazing how close these games are. Bloodthirster shield now giving Kayox a little bit of love. The level 16 Prawley is pretty scary though. Very quick Rift Walks. The item advantage that ROBERTxLEE has on Kayox as well, Last Whisper up.
Interesting how Complexity isn't pushing that advantage that they see they have. Nguyen creates so much pressure, he almost shuts down that fact. We've seen games go, I wouldn't say much quicker, but more definitive in what Complexity wanted to do when these kills were on somebody like ROBERTxLEE. Somebody that can completely kite fights out with constant DPS. Now that's in the favor of Nguyen. See, we're going to have party pressure here. All five members of CounterLogic Gaming. I don't think they know what they want to do, actually.
That wouldn't surprise me.
Middle
if they were...
or bottom? Bottom or middle? How about we split up and actually send one bottom and everyone else middle?
Flying by the seat of their pants. Kayox has said he wants to make the calls here. Hotshot gives him a lot of credit.
All right.
All the knowledge he has with this game right here. Hotshot, though, gets the passive, or the ult on himself as he gets caught.
There's the hit. A lot of focus.
Still in a pretty bad spot. Oh, no!
Oh, my word! The Thresh Express monthly pass.
Look at the smile on Baby's face after that one. He flashed onto the lantern to avoid getting CC'd as he rezzed and not clicking on it. They need to delay as well before his Chrono Shift can come back up again for the next fight. Probably does not want to let that happen.
Uh-oh. Probably is in a great spot here. Even if that ward's there, he can Rift Walk into a great spot for the fight to start. Bubbadub. He's got Glacial Fissure written all over his face.
He
may lose this turret, though.
Look how fast that Chrono Shift came back up. It's a blue buff on Hotshot right now, so he's at 40% CDR. And will we see yet another fight here? Bubbadub gets taken a little low.
Whoa, kick card.
Where's he going?
I don't know, to the back side, but he's needing to get out of the situation right now. Prowley's left alone. Why is everybody going over to the left side? Prowley's able to get out, that's why. He Rift Walks to safety, and a little bit of a back and forth leaves Nguyen, hoping he wasn't dead.
Not the cleanest fight.
Yeah.
By CLG right there. ThinkCard was unable to pull off another amazing kickback, and Complexity focused Nguyen as he dove in as a tank Nidalee. Also, they were able to properly stop focus on Hotshot as he ulted himself. All good things for Complexity as they try and draw this one out late and find a hole in CLG's decision making.
CLG is definitely knocking at the front door. Almost getting the chance to pepper down on inhibitor turrets in just a few minutes. They have the second tier middle to go for. And that top tier right now being guarded by Westrice. 323 to 268 after all in that lane. So with the end back up, they'll be able to go wherever the split push happens.
It's true, actually. I really wonder how threatening that split push really is at this point, though, right? Because he's been pretty effective in the rundown team fights.
Yeah.
It's more about Nguyen getting a wave shoving and then CLG fighting fights 4v5 with a late teleport coming in. All of the big fights in this game have actually been 4v5s with a teleport coming in late or not coming in at all, kind of deciding it. Vroom.
Minions put the sprint on for a second. Seeing the gold across the board. That Chaos sitting on quite a big chunk of change there, as they know pretty much means they're not really in fight mode at the moment, and they want to get back and buy.
He needs a little bit more gold for his Last Whisper. Mm-hmm. When he gets that, he'll be a very real person right there to try and stop Westrice and Kez's Randuins from shutting him down. It's very critical, actually, that he gets that Last Whisper gold. Unless he's going back for defensive item.
A minute on Baron. So that's going to be the wards coming in from Complexity.
No, he got the gold for the last Whisper, just barely there.
Yeah,
All right, good thing.
Calculated.
That's pretty huge.
A lot of plays to be made here. Can Chaox make it happen? It's not really the damage to come out of Nguyen anymore. And he's more or less been sticking with the team. Once they get to those second tier turrets, they're milling about the jungle together. They don't really have a chance to use that teleport once they get up to the top side of the base. Nguyen to the bottom lane. They are going to be able to stretch out complexity a little thinner here in preparation for this Baron. See if it works out. Probably, however, hugging the bottom side. Maybe able to take out Nguyen before any of this happens, if Nguyen doesn't see him first.
Nguyen wants to steal this
that
blue
ward.
Buff. If they can deny probably blue buff, it would give him a pretty nice edge in this next Baron. Look at how tanky he is.
Yeah,
well,
I was just gonna
probably
say.
Barely touches him. Can we feel 5v5 over the blue when Baron's up in 20 seconds? We may well see it. Aye, they got it.
You know, Jat, to mid laners, that feels like your Baron.
It's pretty huge for Prawley's casting,
yeah.
If we're being honest.
Yep.
Maybe even more important than that dragon that CLG just got.
If he can Riftwalk more and keep that mana sustained, he's definitely going to be a menace here. Prawley likes to go ham in these fights. And with Westrice to go in with him, I'm sure they won't stop if they can get one of these kills and turn the heat on. 2,000 gold lead, not meaning much here as we approach 40 minutes in the game. It's all about what they have built on their champions and what they've skilled up. Pretty much max levels across the board now. Nguyen, the only level 18 in the game.
Well,
being pushed back into the base. I don't know if that 18 is going to
help
all that much. Well, there's Chaox. He's 18 too.
Let's see how well Robert conceived the turrets. He gets zero hits on the first wave.
Yeah.
They do get some decent damage. On to Nguyen, it looked like. And it is about Baron vision control right here.
CLG put quite a priority on this a few minutes ago, but those have been swept and or have died out themselves. This is where the complexity can win the game. This is the strategy. They don't have to go outside the box. They have the fight that they want. And this is really where they say they'll have the upper hand against CounterLogic Gaming Subsquad.
And we consider Nguyen and Hotshot, their damage is kind of falling off cliffs right now when in comparison to others. However,
right.
Chaox's damage is taking off. So if Complexity can kill Chaox, he is really the focal point.
Oh, dear.
That's not how Complexity wants to start.
That's the Chaox damage right there, Jad. He can't actually get the finalizing shot. He puts himself too deep, but Hotshot makes sure he puts the chrono shift on. It means they're not focusing Chaox. When it starts to wear off, that's where the focus is. But they don't have time. Beautiful job by CLG.
Oh, no!
The bomb on the backside. Coming up with a kill onto Prowley. Bubbadub still down for 40 seconds. This should be a turret. If anything, CLG can head back to Baron.
And that seems like the name of the game for CLG. No, the turret is actually the choice. Chaox was so safe that fight. Prowley
okay,
could not
get
both to start from Bubbadub. Why not? Why not try to get more long death timers onto Complexity right now? And Hotshot's got his ultimate back up yet again. So being able to focus Chaox is kind of irrelevant right now.
Super Siege Wave in the bottom lane will make up for a little bit. A breath of fresh air for Complexity, but the rest of it, that's stinky. CLG's coming in hard on the inhibitors, and they're going to be able to mess up the base. Chaox stays in range, stays there perfectly, and he gets a nice little tap on the Bloodthirster shield to keep himself safe there on the way out.
The dream is alive for
wow.
The CLG sub-squad. They may actually win an LCS game during the Super Week. They have definitely pulled some strong moves
right.
They
win two, yeah.
That chance to win two. They still got two games left. One after this one, of course. Complexity going Baron, though, with a huge minion wave in the bottom that I feel like CLG has to deal with, but they're going to give it up if they have to. They have to make it to Baron. It's too late. It's too late. The coordination's not there.
Oh, man.
That's real fast, though. Oh, dear.
The Cougar. No, he cannot thread the needle. Baron, once again, going over four dragons as well of the six in this game. One heck of a jump from the end there. Nice lantern toss. Good hop from Chaox. They need to clear out this bottom wave so they don't have much to think about once they get there. Whoa! That's a hell of a lot of damage going out of the turret.
Chaox needs to build another damage item, too. Because he has that chrono shift, and you saw how safe he could stay in that last fight.
That's true.
They need his damage. As well as the death cap being completed on the hotshot. Even though Zillion's damage does fall off pretty heavily, the death cap will increase it substantially.
Blade of the Rune King in there or something. All right, CLG, power in numbers as Complexity starts to take the bottom side. Split push from Westrice.
All right, Chaox built a Banshee's Veil, which is probably the smarter choice. But I'm actually not sure. I think the damage item had its merits. It will prevent Prawly from blowing him up with a death cap Kassadin, however. The death cap is not something Prawly had in the last team fight.
It's true. Chaos still is doing quite a bit of damage. So maybe with just that bit of safety and utility, he can stay on the back line. Because ThinkCard's been making some plays too, delivering them some good kills. Complexity's making sure to not get in any range of a dragon kick for his ultimate. See if Caitlyn can get in range. My eyes on ROBERTxLEE here. Great traps going down, so they really can't get the engage on, and his focus is to be on the turret. He's the only one that can do it, and it's still high risk. Wow, their waves.
Take was real critical. Yeah, COG not the best at managing these waves, as is to be expected for a team that has never really played together before.
Your team's turret has been destroyed.
It's different. All these things kind of come into play, and they just happen when you watch the teams that have played together for years. But it's definitely something that has to be put on the list and prioritized. It's something that can fall to the wayside if you're not playing with a team that synergizes all that well in the late game. Good damage onto ThinkCard. He's been one of the initiators, so he's not doing any flashy jump-ins right now. Nguyen also going down to half HP, but unfortunately, not the timing of a wave here for ROBERTxLEE and team to get those last shots on the turret. Just waiting this one out. You look at Prawly wants to get over that wall and kill someone.
That trap line is making it very difficult for CLG to pile in for an initiation as well. With Nguyen gone, it may mean the end of this turret. Let's see how Robert approaches this. Will CLG go in? Nice flay, actually.
All right.
And they get Bubbadub yet again.
Bubbadub, huge damage. Kez also Bubbadub with the burn on.
Man.
Very nicely saved with his shield. Puts down the Locket of the Iron Solari and the Face of the Mountain. Keeping himself nice and safe. 45 minutes into this one as we press on to 46. It does look like Complexity can break that bottom wall.
We got ourselves a game, that's for sure.
This static shiv, turtle mode from Chaos and the rest of the team really paying off.
Yeah, the Tristana with that type of range at this late in the game makes it very difficult to push against. Even though Prawly is reaching some pretty scary points with his item build. I wonder if he goes defensive on Kassadin or if he starts building towards a Lich Bane.
Huh.
He's got interesting. A few options here. Hotshot's going defensive.
You always have that Spectral Cow already. See if anybody else has some recipe items. Also, could have a Banshee's Veil on Baby. We're getting to that late game. Randuin's omen for Bubbadub when he gets himself in the fight. All right, CLG pushing down the mid lane. Let's see what they can push. And can it be past this inhibitor? It's going to be quite a fight. All members of Complexity setting up the turtle here. 14 to 10. It's been quite a bloodbath as well, coming in with 24 kills overall in this game. 75,000 just about between both teams here.
And it is an exposed inhibitor, Riv, but the fights have been anything but clean this game. I really wonder how they can get another catch. I mean, you can only land so many death sentences as a Thresh, it seems like, yet... he doesn't get that one. And here comes Complexity.
Whoa, ThinkCard into the back, kicks away ROBERTxLEE, so he can do damage from the outside. I like the thought, but is it enough? Chaos is going to start firing off. Westrice is his target. They take down Prawly and Hotshot. Mid laners out of the fight. The next focus is going to be Chaos. In the end, trying to run to the backside, and they do keep alive the last Primal Surge, but Complexity is on a tear here. In the end can't get out. Yes, there's the Lantern once again from Baby.
Hotshot is down with his Chrono Shift on cooldown.
Whoa,
there was too much lockdown for him to get this. Complexity is chasing so fast. In the end, he's in range.
Westrice, he hits it. The Guardian Angel is leaving him to just go deeper and deeper in this fight, dodging out the death sentence, which probably would have put him under the turret for a long time. And now Complexity turns the tide. They don't even let CLG hit their inhibitor. And now they are back at CLG's base.
I do not know why Nguyen turned around at the end there. Geez, that was a chaotic fight. He's teleporting. He is teleporting into their base. He wants the inhibitor. Oh, no! Teleport!
Uh-oh. He's going.
I don't think he can stop him. This will be fun. He wants it!
He's going to get it. He might actually even make it a little farther. That's a lot of focus. That was great, because now Counterlodge Gaming is kind of roaming free. They can set up some wards here and bide some time off of that. Complexity does not get the chance to continue their push down mid lane. They all had to teleport back to to their base.
They burned a lot to go defend him. It does dissuade the push when they had a man advantage. It's also a long death timer.
Ooh.
Nguyen trying to be a hero. Same with Chaox with that red steel. Channeling another CLG AD carry. Late game red buff steals sometimes proving fatal. This time it is not fatal.
You did get it.
For Chaox, they're 49 minutes in.
So many bubbles.
This is the danger of Nguyen pushing mid though, is the counter push down the same mid lane in a 4v5.
Look at this.
Chaox is strong enough.
Oh! Can't kill the bubble boy.
Damage. Hey!
Oh, hot shot.
Hey! So many escapes.
And shields.
Probably
one
not
shot,
having his
very
best
nice.
Hit. You can see he had to build that chain vest because Chaox is just targeting him out in team fights. And they got 7 seconds till Nguyen is alive. Looks like they can hold.
Wow, chat, what a game. Coming up on 50 minutes now. So good. Counter Logic Gaming pulling themselves together here as Complexity wants to get another win on the split. Obviously, it's 7-8 right now.
Look at the size of that minion wave in the bottom lane as well.
Gotta get it.
As we're talking about this game, sure, Complexity's doing Baron, but they are exposing a lot. This is a collapse down. They're going to get Baron. 2,000 health right here. No steal.
Smite down. Third Baron of the game to Complexity. Isn't enough to take it, though. ThinkCard's going to be in the fire. He goes down as he tries to make the exit. That's what's been saving Counter Logic Gaming. Do they have enough now if they have to stay in the fight full force? Chaox, Orb walking it out. He's got a lot of shots, but they flash on top of him. That looked promising for a quick second, but Complexity shut it down. Double bomb coming from Hotshot GG, and he gets a double kill there.
And he burned the GA of Westrice, but the rest of CLG was dying there.
Ooh, that's
and
huge.
And this game has gone on far too long. My voice is falling apart here. 51 minutes of chaos, but will this be the end of it? There's a lot of death timers in Hotshot. He needs
this
to make it back to base fast.
Finally, the best situation. It could be better. They could have more, but they do have Caitlyn. They have ROBERTxLEE turrets now, and they're going to be able to take down that inhibitor turret. Hotshot. Maybe able to do only so much here, throw out a few bombs for a consolation prize, but they're going to lose their inhibitor.
I mean, I wonder how much more they're going to lose. Complexity plays it conservatively, but Azilian is not the best base defender. He was able to take out the minions, and there are no other minion waves pushing, so that is all they are going to lose. They lose the Baron, lose the fight, they lose their inhibitor, but they do not lose the game yet.
Very fast, just overall movement, Complexity being on top of it.
All right, so a big thing about here is Chaox unfortunately shot Westrice backwards instead of forwards, which meant when he tried to peel off, he was still getting stunned. Hotshot correctly ultimated him this time, though, so he was able to come back up. Tries to pull some fancy footwork, but there's enough tankiness and sustain, and all the low targets were tanky that he can't get them.
Yeah.
The double bomb obliterates Complexity right there, but it just wasn't enough. As much as Chaox was able to shoot Complexity, he realizes now the error of his ways with that Banshee's Veil. He has taken a Phantom Dancer lesson. He needs more damage.
Yeah.
Because he's really all they have as far as damage goes. It is what he needs to do at this stage in the game. With all the tankiness that Complexity has built up, he needs it.
They have it as well.
I'm surprised he didn't go Blade of the Rune King, actually.
That's what I was thinking he was going to go.
Yeah, it's because of the Thornmail on Westrice. Without double lifesteal items, it actually hurts Chaox to hit him.
Right.
With the Thornmail, which will be a huge bad thing. Plus, he has enough attack speed anyway.
No, whoa.
He is fearless. He doesn't need no lantern.
He don't need no stinking lantern. He's good to go. All right, so Chaox keeps himself safe. He also working as the face of the mountain. Mikhail's looking at a locket of the Iron Solaris. Baby gets that finished up as well, so they have a lot to keep him safe. He's also working with his summoner heal, but... Look at this Goldie, 91,000 to 79 now.
Yeah, it has really stretched. But the itemization is close to max.
It is.
If COG can get about another 5 or 10,000 gold in their pocket, everyone will be at max builds, except for the supports.
One of these days we'll get a max support game, you know. It'll be like 80 minutes or something.
We had one of those.
Oh yeah!
The supports still weren't max out.
No, I'm kidding.
They need slots to buy their wards. Poor fellas.
All right, so Static Shiv doing work on the top lane, but can he get back in time for the bottom? CLG spread thin without that AD carry here to close out those wards, or close out those waves. Waiting for the cupcake line to be set up, and then Complexity can have a little more fun at the stairs of CLG's base.
I mean, this is the late game that Complexity was relying on to be stronger than. They have tanked up to think they have enough to deal with Chaos's Trist, and they're hoping to just kind of ignore everyone else on CLG. It's a tank Nidalee, a Zillion, and a tank Lee Sin. See how much turret damage they can get with Chaos away. There's nothing for Complexity to fear here with no Tristana.
Very hectic. The Glacial Fissure goes down. ThinkCard actually tries to get himself in the fight. This could be him going down. He does get the Chrono Shift, but it's very low CLG members and not a lot of Rocket Home Guards. We actually have a Fuhrer. Oh, they are. I was looking at Chaos. He's only one with Fuhrers on, and he's staying in the fight. So the Home Guards are providing a bit of utility, but not enough to save the inhibitor.
It really seems like Complexity has found their stride, but Chaos can happen sometimes.
I was thinking, you're going to kick Prowly and he's just going to walk away, but he had no chance to kick him anyways. Alt down, and EN brute forcing Complexity out of the base here with a bit of the power that he brings to the table, and they're forced to listen. They got what they wanted, and they're not going to try to stretch that advantage. Very big plays from Complexity here to get what they want, and just getting out alive.
CLG made a pretty big mistake there, using Chaos as their split push defender. Because their entire team at this stage in the game is built around him.
That's the only reason they couldn't get to that bottom inhibitor last time. Mm-hmm. Static shift.
Now with two inhibitors down, Complexity will group for the third. And now CLG will be forced into using Chaos as that defender because he's the only one who can clear the minions. Oh, never mind. The middle inhibitor did respawn. So they're not in that big of a pickle yet. Soon, though, they will be.
That top wave actually might just get evened out before it gets all the way to that turret. It is in CLG's favor. It'll be something they can work. No, Prowly's going to crush it down. I like what they're thinking. They're not going to give CLG anything to work off of. Even if they get a fight, they're going to have to face tank everything. And right now, that's going to be an open inhibit mid for both teams. Complexity is forcing down mid lane as they wait for Prowly. This is my favorite kind of part of pushes, the patience of the team. Complexity knows to kite any fights that are going to happen here. And CLG knows that they have to try and spread themselves thin, but do that accordingly. It's going to get tough.
Yeah, Complexity trying to take this steady. Baby needs to find a catch on a priority target. They do have ROBERTxLEE's flash down, but he has a GA as well. So it's going to be difficult even if they do catch him out. Those are big shots. Ah! Chaos has again corrected his build. Now he has the Blade of the Ruin kit.
Yeah. He's got a lot of coupons. ThinkCard goes in again. ThinkCard's been doing this. He draws out the Glacial Fissure actually every time he does. They lose the inhibitor, but they also dodged a pretty big ultimate there. We'll see if they can recuperate. It's really not working in their favor, anything they do, but they're trying.
This looks like the end for old CLG. It'll have to become 1-3 the dream instead of 2-2 the dream for these guys. Looks like Complex is going to close him out here. Last ditch effort from CLG, but it looks like Prowly's going to keep up a split push threat in the base.
Right. If this doesn't work, we're getting another Baron. That's up in 3 seconds, but I'm quite sure that this could be one of the final fights. Chaos still forced to fight on the other side of the map with Prowly. Hotshots, bombs, they're doing the trick so far to clear the waves, but it's a matter of time. We saw it in the bottom lane, that turret's going down soon. Yen and the team,
they're
doing what they can.
Peeling back for Baron. I heavily disagree with this call by Complexity. Doing this will actually allow Chaos time to clear the waves and may allow the inhibitors to respawn for CLG so that eventually they could force a heads up 5v5, which is ultimately what CLG needs to do if they want a chance in this game. Baron will make Complexity stronger, and if they can get back to the base before the inhibitors respawn, it's a decent move. See, they're actually not going back to shop here. They're using the Baron buff to continue their push, and probably will teleport in. So, overall, smart move by Complexity. I just thought they were going to go back to base after that Baron.
Two more minutes, and we got an hour. Complexity games just blow my mind. They can somehow do this each time and stretch out their opponent for the long... I think they just play like a physical game of League of Legends. They're like, we'll tire them out. We're Rocky. They're not. Let them hit us.
All right. Here we go.
Crazy teleport!
And a blue inhibitor is respawned, right? They don't have long to do this. It's got to be this wave.
Good focus. ROBERTxLEE on the backside. He is going to take that down. Bubbadub and Westrice into the middle of the fight. These are the ults we were looking for. Baby goes down, and so does the turret. Chaox gets what he can, but he's so slow, he cannot orb walk enough to get in the shots that he wants. Westrice still low. They could get through this one without losing anybody, but get everybody through just pretty much limping and bleeding to the finish line.
Chaos, some kill.
Oh, still there. He goes down, not able to keep himself alive. Hot shot going down on the fountain. CLG gets aced. Complexity keeps everyone alive by some manner. And they're going to be able to take down the Nexus. No, they won't hit 60 minutes. They get a pre-hour win.
Of
CLG
course.
Loses to Complexity at 59 minutes.
I mean, come on. 59 minutes, that's hardly a long game for Complexity, but really, what a game there by the CLG substitutes to stick around this long against Complexity. It was a very important game, actually, for both teams when you consider playoff and promotion implications. Complexity out of the playoffs, yet still wanting that seventh seed so they get a better choice of who to play from the Challenger Series. And CLG would have really loved that win because they are at risk of falling into sixth place.
That's right. There we are. Complexity taking down Counter Logic Gaming. Quite a game. Very great early play from CLG. Nguyen's Diddly was just going crazy all over the place. His roam really helped control a lot of what Prolly would create in the late game, is that map pressure. Once Complexity got that map pressure, what Nguyen did was all for naught.
Really seemed like it. Nguyen has been playing very well.
Yeah, that's a true
and
statement.
It really feels like he would have a place on an LCS team if he wanted to be on one. Remember at the start of this split, or in between splits, Nguyen stepped down from CLG. So CLG right. then had to scramble and pick up Seraph as a replacement. He is still an LCS caliber top laner, and he's proven it these three games.
He absolutely has. I think his time away actually allowed him to do things that he needed to do to become a better player as well, because it was a very tight position he was in during his time on Counter Logic Gaming. Complexity coming out with another win. Definitely a bowl of whipped cream on this one. They were able to come out pretty strong, keep it consistent at the hour-long range, and that's consistency for you.
Koob's actually clarified his bowl of whipped cream reference later. It's not just like, oh, they did well, let's give them whipped cream. It's depending on the personality of the person. You either kind of give them compliments if they're a player who tilts
right.
easily, or if they're like a really arrogant person, you got to knock them down a peg or two.
Yeah. You can't
bowl of feces, apparently. That's another word for it.
That's what I would have thought of.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Be like, you know what? You deserve this.
Yeah.
Be like, thanks, coach.
You're too confident. 59 minutes is too slow. Here you go.
So we'll see what they come back with tomorrow. A very strong game. There's Koobs right there talking to Prolly, saying, yeah, you guys did get casted all the way through. Third pick on red side. And I think that kind of sent Complexity for a loop there. Use that quite accordingly. And we see Hotshot GG on the screen bringing Zillion back out for another play. And they actually had quite good play coming into this one. As well.
CLG is getting so close to winning. Like, they really just need a few extra things to go their way. Their final game, unfortunately, is against Cloud9 tomorrow. So their most formidable opponent of the week will come when they're the strongest team, because they do improve again and again. And that game is most likely going to matter for Cloud9. We'll see whether it's for first place or to secure second.
And it's unfortunate that Xerath bugged out this week, too. Talking to Hotshot GG earlier, he's like, yeah, I would have loved to play that. But obviously, understand the reasoning. Coming into this, that's going to be hard for CLG to bring a game off of Cloud9 with now playing a few of the same around. That Nidalee is huge in Nguyen's hands, but will they be able to pull it out with having such a short amount of time to synergize as a team?
And will we see a Zillion ban? It seems a little obnoxious.
It does seem obnoxious. Right now, however, we're going to throw it over to Dash, who's joined by Complexity's bottom lane.
Thanks, Riv. I want to welcome ROBERTxLEE and Bubbadub from Complexity after a win against CLG. Congratulations on that one. Robert, I want to hit you with a question straight off the bat, which is that earlier in the split, you tweeted out, how do you play against a team that doesn't know what they're doing? Well, I will now pose that question to you. How do you play against a team that doesn't quite know what they're doing against CLG?
Well, I'd say that we didn't know what we were doing either, so it was two teams that didn't know what they're doing, and hence the 60-minute game, or almost 60-minute game.
So, well, okay, so in that case, when both teams are scrambling to figure each other out, how do you make mid-game adaptations based on the new information that you're getting as the game plays out?
Well, Nidalee became a problem. She got a really big lead over Irelia, which made the game hard to control the map. But then after some Kassadin plays here and there, we got a pick here and there, we were able to control the objectives and we were just playing around them.
And Bubbadub, you got to play against a couple veterans of the LCS as one of the newcomers. What's that experience like to play against some legends, people that you probably heard about and followed back when they played?
Well, I know Hotshot thinks I feed a lot, so I had to try not to feed too much this game. But other than that, I mean, I would say that it's fun, but at the same time, I didn't feel like I should have, or the game shouldn't have been that close, I should say.
Fair enough. Well, let's look at why the game was that close then. Yeah. Just out of curiosity, we've seen the Zillion come out, and Hotshot's been playing it a bunch. How do you play against a Zillion? Because essentially what that means is that every person on the other team has a GA, right? And you're not really sure who it is going to be and who it's going to put on. So what's targeting like in team fights?
I would say Zillion's kind of bad against hard engage, but we didn't have any of that. We had a bunch of split, and I think Zillion was a really good pick there because they were able to chase us down if we tried to split too much. And I think it showed a little bit because they got a lot of good fights off. And anytime we wanted to fight, they just back off. And we didn't have hard engage because Elise and Braum aren't really good at hard engage. Our hard engage was like Cassidy and Riff walking in.
All right. Well, I want to take a look at a replay real quick. We're about 50 minutes in. It's around the Baron pit. You guys go 4-for-2 and take the Baron. So if you don't mind, Robert, walking me through this one.
So what are we doing here? The call was to burn Baron. We get the Baron. I'm just hitting the front line while the rest of my team is like creating chaos with chaos. And when the Zillion or Jasana got popped, we immediately turned for Jasana and we immediately just chased them down. And at that point we were almost went 4-for-0, but then the Zillion just, oh my god.
Yeah, the Zillion bomb wreaking havoc.
Yeah, I saw all my whole team like at low HP, and I was like, where did half my team go?
Yep. Where did my team
go? Combusting. Well, after that, you guys, you know, methodically close out the game. It took a little bit of time. As you said, it's hard to siege up against that. You don't have the hard engage, and you were able to close out the game. But I now want to look kind of into the future a little bit. Unfortunately, you guys are now sitting outside of playoffs in that seventh spot. So looking ahead towards relegations, what are you guys looking to do as a team to like regroup in mindset and re-qualify?
I would say that the only thing that we're working on is ourselves and just to get better as a team. As you can see, we're notorious for being unable to close out games, and that's just something that we just need to work on as a team.
Well, and to that end, Bubbadub, how do you feel that the team has improved over the whole split? Because this has been 28 games of evolution, right, for Complexity. Granted, you have one more game tomorrow, so I guess 27 games of evolution for Complexity. How do you feel the journey's been?
It's been a long journey, and I would say that at the start, we were falling apart pretty much as soon as the game started. First 5-10 minutes would pretty much decide the game. And if we didn't get a huge lead early, we would lose the game. And then we progressed. We're able to get leads early game and go even early game and get into the mid game where we'd basically stall out and hope that late game our composition would be able to carry us to victory. And now I'd say we're making a lot more mid game moves. So it's definitely moving in a positive direction. And I think next split, we could definitely make playoffs.
Absolutely. Do you feel like the acquisition of Kez, you know, in the middle of the split, or I guess in the first third of the split, was a plus, right? You were 1-7 before that. My question is whether or not you feel you could have done better with him off the get-go.
Kez brought a whole different aura with the team. Before, we would either go too ham or too passive. And I'd say, and Kez really plays around the objectives, which is how I feel the game should actually be played compared to, hey, should we fight here? I don't know. Let's go flip a coin. All right, heads, let's fight. That's kind of how it was before.
I'd like to see that if you took the time to like flip a coin before making that decision.
You see on our camera, and we're like, what are they doing? Oh,
They're going in.
It's their decision-making process. At least when it lands, you have, like, everyone's got to follow it, right?
Mm-hmm.
That'd be a very interesting way to see a game played out if everything had to be done by the flip of a coin. All right, well, looking at tomorrow, right, you play EG, the team currently in eighth. They have two games tomorrow. So tomorrow's game is going to decide kind of that positioning there at the bottom of the bracket. So how important is that game coming in with a very strong plan and the win?
Yeah, definitely beating EG tomorrow would be our most important match because it decides who's 7th and 8th. And looking at the challenger scene, I would say that Coast would be the strongest challenger team. And I feel like they're with the skill difference between Coast and, let's say, whoever the second place team is very big. And it's really important that we don't play them during relegations.
All right. Well, we've got that game coming up right now. We're going to watch Coast play. So it'll be very interesting to see them perform, especially in that LAN setting. Are you guys going to stick around and watch that game, Bubbadub?
Maybe. I like to watch these games from the comfort of my own home normally. So I'll probably head home and then tune in.
That's fair. Kick the shoes off, lay back on the couch and all that junk. I like it. All right, guys. Well, thank you very much for joining me on the desk. Congratulations on the win. Best of luck in tomorrow's match against EG. I know it's an important one. Now we're going to throw it back over to Riv and Jat at the caster's desk.
Thank you very much, Dash. And six more games are in the match history. And here's where things stand in North American LCS. In first place, it's LMQ. That's going to be followed by Cloud9 in second.
One game back in third, it is TSM, but they're still close with COG and Dignitas tied for fourth.
Then taking that last playoff spot, it's Curse in sixth, with Complexity in seventh and EG in last. But tomorrow, all will be decided in our last day of the 2014 Summer Split. We'll get things going with Evil Geniuses versus Complexity.
Then Dignitas will challenge LMQ, followed by Curse taking on TSM.
And after that, Evil Geniuses will return to the Rift to battle LMQ. And barring any tiebreakers, we'll draw the split to a close with Cloud9 versus Counter Logic Gaming. That's all happening on Sunday, noon Pacific, 9 Central European time. Set your watches. Now we've got to take a quick break, but keep that browser tuned right here for the North American Challenger Series Finals. It's going to be good.
Back in my day,
when I was a young whippersnapper,
Back in my day, you could start Ramus Q with a ward.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
That blue pill, and they have to stay in. Oh, the flash! ROBERTxLEE hitting up Bubbadub. They actually get the double knockup. What a play for CLG.
There's the hit. A lot of focus.
Stealing it for two bands, but oh no!
Oh, my word! Do they have enough now if they have to stay in the fight full force? Chaos, Orb walking it out. He's got a lot of shots, but they flash on top of him. That looked promising for a quick second, but Complexity shut it down. Just pretty much limping and bleeding to the finish line. Chaos,
kill.
Oh, still there. He goes down, not able to keep himself alive. Hotshot going down on the bottom.